からみんなでめちゃくちゃ踊って騒ごう騒ごう。
Ladies and gentlemen, we just had to give you a sample of what took place the other night in Newark, New Jersey, when the whole entire world feasted their eyes on one of the greatest entertainers of our era.
Wow.
I'm not even going to say generation.
Wow.
Generation is 2 decades, Mike Muse.
Yes.
That's 20 years.
20 years, man.
We're saying of era, multiple Grammy Awards, tens of millions of records sold. That's on her own. That's not even including the records she's collaborated with or the hits she made for artists or the artists she made from hits.
That works front and back.
See what we're doing with this. Always true to form. Before people were talking about inequality, before people were talking about independence, before people were talking about female empowerment, she's been the living manifestation of that.
Oh, wow.
She's always been in control as far as I'm concerned. And then her affinity for hip-hop culture.
Mm-hmm.
I heard her say something in her speech the other day when she won the Michael Jackson Video Vanguard Award. I want to play a piece of it that really stood out to me. And then I'm going to introduce who we have here if you don't already know.
I want to dedicate this award to the dance community all around the world, because when y'all get on the stage with these artists, it is not, y'all are not just props. Y'all are the icing on the cake. Y'all are the beat to the heart. And so I dedicate this to every dance community out there, and including these hard workers who come here, the little ones. This is the next generation, and I promise y'all, I love y'all with all my heart. If my heart could speak, you would know how grateful I am. I'm so grateful. I'm humbled.
Rightfully so. Her video game changed the landscape of how we view videos, how we express ourselves through visual imaging. She talked about dance culture had to be, as you know, through hip-hop. We all came through dance culture.
That's a fact.
Right?
Yes.
We all. You look at Jermaine Dupri. You look at J-Lo. You look at Rosie Perez. You look at P. Diddy.
Yeah.
We all. You look at Missy Elliott.
Yeah.
You look at Swiggity.
Yeah.
Yo, come on, man. You know I was doing that on Pier 39 with King Tech.
No, but we didn't see that.
I was passing the hat around. That was me.
Oh,
ladies
was
and gentlemen, welcome Missy Elliott to the Missy,
what an introduction.
Thank you.
We love you.
We
Thank
do.
You. I love
yes.
y'all.
You know how often Heather is constantly.
Oh, you know, this is my sister right here.
Amen.
Yeah. She, people come up here, they don't even ask about you. And Heather reminds he can be a Heather's gonna remind them. What you say about Missy, Heather?
She is the greatest female artist of our time.
Amen. Yes.
Well, when you talk about women who came into the game, for us being recognized as women in hip hop, you have to put Missy on the top of the list. That's not taken away from anybody, because in my eyes, Missy has always embraced other female artists. At a time when female artists were pitted against each other, Missy always embraced. But then there's another skill set of being able to have a pen game so potent that you can write for other people and you don't even hear the artist that wrote it.
Wow.
That's a separate skill set.
Uh-huh.
And in my opinion, what you did, you and Tim did with Aaliyah, to me, goes down in history. That album, that Aaliyah album, and those songs.
Uh-huh.
And when people found out, like, that was Missy, and like, that was just incredible. And it just continued and continued. You think of 702, you think of Total, you think of Monica, the list goes on, and on and on.
Maya.
Keisha Cole's. I mean, you're talking about a list of
Mary.
Women, that she's always embraced. It's incredible. So you can't mention women in music without mentioning Missy Elliott.
Ooh.
That's from the heart.
Thank you. Thank you. That's I need to come up here every day.
That's right. I tell you, Missy.
I feel good.
you know, we have to do it now. You know what I mean? While
Thank
you're here.
You.
And then also when we talk, we like to inform folks who may not realize, you know, you can't keep tooting your own horn. That's, you know, that feels vain after a while.
She said beep, beep. Beep, beep.
But I promise the citizens that we'll let a citizen ask you the first question. Okay, so Jeff is in Ohio. Go ahead, Jeff.
Big Jeff, what's popping?
Hey, Jeff.
Make it good, Jeff.
You're the first.
Okay, I want to know. Hello?
Yeah, go ahead. Talk in the phone, Jeff. Go ahead.
Okay, I wanted to know, how was your collaboration with Timbaland? Did he give the beat first, or did you write, and then you look in his catalog and say, okay, I want this beat to go with this song? How did that work?
Oh, no. Me and Tim, we always in the studio together, and he'll go through sounds, and I'll be like, you know, that's hot, or that's not. And we like pretty much, we're in the studio. Every album, I have been in the studio for every record. And so he'll, you know, hit stuff. And I know when I hear something, I'll be like, oh, okay, I can write to that one. And nah, that's, we finna be blackballed out here with these records. because we got some most definitely records that should never come out.
Why not?
Because they whack. Oh. everything ain't gonna always be. No, I can't say they whack, you know, okay. To us, because our expectations for ourselves is high. But in Tim, he can't really make a whack beat for real. Yeah. But, you know, that's pretty much how it's always been. I've been in the studio with him, and he'll go through sounds. And Tim is always a genius when it comes to placing music together, because, you know, he it's not that he went to school for this. Mm-hmm. It's just that he has an ear that's like none other. Mm-hmm. And I say that, I'll say that till it's my last breath. He is a genius, like truly a genius.
Has he ever imposed on you to do a song that you didn't think would be great?
Totally.
Well, can you name a couple of them that you was like, this ain't gonna work, and then it ended up blowing up?
I hated Gossip Folks.
Really?
Oh, wow.
Yes. I hated Gossip Folks. And he was like, I'm telling you, this, that, knock. And I'm like, yo, excuse my voice. I've been sick, so I know I sound crazy.
Well, you just got a Video Vanguard Award. Don't worry, we'll give you a pass, Missy. It's cool. Okay.
Yeah, I hated Gossip Folks. And you know, it's that whole album actually was funny, because we thought that we had, he thought that we completed. And that's how we challenge each other, because it was like, you know, this album is done. He said, this album done. And I'm like, nah, it's something missing. It is something missing from this album. And he was in the studio. And when Tim get in his way, he done. Like, if he say it's done, it's done. And so I'm like, Tim, nah, we missing something. And he just go, the press start pressing the keys all hard because he mad.
He's doing
and then I hear, dum, 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 dum. And I'm like, whoa, wait a minute, what was that? And he was like, what you talking about? And by that time, he had went past that sound now, because he's so mad, he just pressing buttons. And I'm like, no, go back, keep pressing, because I know I heard something. And it's so funny, because Get Your Freak On was the last record that I did that ended up being the first record from that album. But that's the, and like I always tell people with Work It, he pushed me, because it took 5 verses. And every time I kept coming in the room, like, is this it? He like, nah, that ain't it. And he like, it's all right. And then by the 5th time, I'm tired. I'm like, this gonna come out. I don't care how it's done. So by that time, he was like, nah, that's it. That's
damn,
it.
So man, I want to hear a little bit of this, man. This is the 5th attempt.
Wow.
This is the 5th attempt?
Yes.
Damn, Missy Elliott rewrites verses. Young artists, listen to that, okay?
It's okay.
Wow, wait, hold up, man. That line always escaped my mind.
What's up? It should have taught you some things.
Eat it like a vulture?
Yeah.
Facts. You know, vultures eat dead meat.
Dead meat. You got them?
No, okay. So
they eat like they hungry.
Damn,
right.
Jesus. Eat it like a vulture. Damn, Missy.
Put some swang on it, though. Swang. Yeah, you make like vulture. Sound. She ain't say it like that.
Eat it like a vulture. Yeah. So the reverse in that.
That was a mistake.
What do you mean that was a mistake? That's the standout part of the song.
I know. The engineer, I heard something and I was like, yo, take it backwards. And it was my vocal going backwards. And I was like, let me just work around that. So for years, if you could know the things that people thought. This ain't on TV or nothing, right?
People
was thinking. Nah, I was saying, is your pussy wet yet?
Is your pussy wet yet?
Is your pussy wet yet?
Oh, your pussy wet yet? Hold up, damn, we getting to the bottom of this.
Wow. Now how hard I gotta work yet? Is your pussy wet yet?
How do you hear that?
Is your motherfucking pussy wet? Yeah. That's what I like.
Is your pussy wet?
I was singing the wrong thing to people's ears. Okay.
No, I was singing that.
I'm dying.
I swear. My bad.
Missy, is it ever like uncomfortable, even thinking about Drip Demeanor off of this project, is it ever uncomfortable when you just flexing your sexual empowerment in front of Tim?
Never.
Okay.
Oh, because you know what? I've never recorded in front of anybody. Like, no one has ever seen me record. I record myself. So, Timberland, you know, Pharrell, nobody. Busta tell you. He done tried to bust in the room a few times. I had a door so tight, locked. Yeah. And I only do that because I like to be comfortable. And I know that if I'm in a room and I go to make a moan noise or something, like that'll right. be like.
Bus will be like, sis, you cool? She all right in there? She had a stomachache.
Hell, Sway.
So, you know, I never recorded in front of them. So I'll be fine.
That song, Tracy was read. Can you read some of the lyrics?
Oh, I can.
Can you?
So Missy says he just want to get me hot. He just trying to get my twat.
Okay, what did you mean by that?
anybody from down south know what twat is.
Okay,
that's
okay.
You know.
Okay.
That's a y'all don't know what twat.
We know it up north too. Don't.
Or did y'all figure it out because of what it's about? Or do they say that up here? No.
No, they say that. I'm from the town. Yeah. I'm from Oakland. We say twat. Cause you know we say it all, Missy. Y'all, Virginia probably got it from us. Okay.
No,
okay.
Wow. We used to say poo poo too. So
poo poo.
Yeah,
oh. Poo-poo.
Eat the poo poo.
Oh wow.
New York is a big pussy. Pussy's New York's word.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Right. What else it says?
Okay. He want a taste of my goodies. He say it tastes like butterscotch.
Okay. Damn.
Boy, you cannot get me locked. You trying to get? I'm trying to get you blocked. I'm missing.
Boy, you'll get blocked.
Boy, you'll get blocked. Boom. Unless you're trying to marry me, my ring must be big as a rock. I open up my candy shop. My panties drop.
Oh shit, Missy, go on, girl.
Hey.
I'm getting bothered up in here, Missy.
Right. Start moaning and boo.
Whoa, get that boo poo.
Listening, I'm like, oh really? Did I say all that?
You like that? No, we got sound effects. Would you? Have you thought about ever being married?
Oh, I most definitely. You know, but to be honest. Right now, I'm just living in the moment. I haven't even thought about anything but music. My label has made sure of that. Mm-hmm. Yeah. I can't do nothing but try to finish this album.
Mm-hmm.
That's where I'm at.
What's been the best part of taking a break from music?
Ooh, geez, a peace of mind.
Peace of mind. It's yes. necessary, though, right?
Yes. It is. Your brain is like a computer. You have to refresh, like, or it's gonna crash. I don't care how great, you know, you are. You have to take a second. And for me, it's just a peace of mind. Like, it's a lot.
Mm-hmm.
You know, a lot of people want to be artists until they understand what comes with it. Because for the people on the outside, they just see the glory of it, but they don't see what goes on behind the scenes. For many artists. Mm-hmm. And, you know, even I look now and I see a lot of artists who suffer from depression and anxiety and all different things. And I'd say, you know, I've been there, so I know what that is.
Mm-hmm.
But it's a lot being an artist. You have to love it. It can't be that I just woke up one day and seen that everybody's doing it and I do it.
Yeah.
You know, we come from a place of, you're passionate about it.
Yeah, because it's going to hurt.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
It hurts.
Oh, yeah. Hell yeah.
You know, it can hurt. What are some of the pitfalls about being an artist, even as you as successful as you are, that artists don't realize going into the game you're going to have to face?
Oh, some of the pitfalls are you have to be prepared to know that there will be ups and downs.
Okay.
Like, you know, that's one of the things that I think makes people fall into depression, because they may come out and they may blow up.
Uh-huh.
And then all of a sudden a record don't hit. And then, you know, all the things that people was right there, like right by your side, you need this, you need that.
Uh-huh.
And then they not there no more. Mm. Then you just start losing it, because it's like you don't have that control
uh-huh.
no more. And that's one of the things I think, because people think that you're going to be hot forever.
Yeah.
You won't be hot forever. You may always get respect.
Yeah.
If you done right.
Uh-huh.
But you won't be hot forever. You, I don't care. At 80,
mm-hmm.
you might not have no joint on the charts.
Yeah.
But when you walk in that room at 80, if you do right, then people will always respect you. Patti LaBelle, she can come in and people going to always be like, oh, my God, that's mm-hmm. Patti LaBelle.
Yep.
Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Uh-huh. So that's Stevie Wonder.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so that's the thing is you got to prepare yourself for the ups and downs. And when it's just, you know, a new slew coming in and, mm-hmm. and you have to prepare yourself for that.
What does the preparation look like? Like, if there was a new artist getting in the game and speaking to you, what would you say for them to have in the queue?
Humility.
Mm. Oh.
Round up. Yeah.
Humility. Yeah. And relationships is everything. Because as long as you have relationships, you always work and you always get a check. Because people are going to always look out for you. Mm. Humility is everything.
Oh, yeah. Lost art.
Lost art of humility. All right.
Hey, Missy, I have a question for you. Speaking of artists and
that's
artists,
Mike Muse, Missy.
I know, Mike.
Good seeing you again, Missy.
Yes.
Speaking of artistry, I don't look at you as a music artist. I think you're transcendent. I don't think you're just music. I think you're like visual artists, fashion, art, photography. Oh, wow. So you just, to me, you're in that realm. And I'm just curious. I've always wanted to know what is inside that beautiful mind of yours that allows you to come up with the way you scat and your raps and the visuals from your videos and your outfits and your costumes and how it all comes together so brilliantly, because it could be a mess in certain areas if you weren't so particular. It's very Jackson Pollock almost, if you will. And so I'm just curious, like, what informs you about that? Is it, did you read comic books growing up? Did you go to art galleries?
Only child.
Like, what's the thing?
Only child. Mm. I had no one to play with, so I had to create all. And it's weird that when I say that, I believe, like, when you're an only child and you don't have any brothers and sisters, you have to create. And I know everybody had a couple of friends that it was imaginary.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
I know you.
Still
but,
do.
You know, you still maybe have. Oh, because you're the only child?
Oh, no, I'm the youngest of three, but so I'm not about, don't hate on my youth. Don't do that to me, Missy, because I have protection. Just be only child jealousy.
Oh, you got siblings.
Okay.
Well, people, that's only, for me, I was the only child, so I pretty much created a Alice in Wonderland in my room, and I had a couple of imaginary friends. Don't think I'm crazy, because I don't know where they at now. But I just want y'all to know that I want y'all to be like, where they at? But, and I just always been, you know, someone that gravitated to things like watching Michael, you know, and even a artist like Peter Gabriel, who a lot of people might not know, but I used to watch his videos and be like, why is his head ticking like that? And those things always intrigued me. And I just always been a sound effect person. I always used to watch cartoons and try to mimic the sound effects. And I just, you know, said, I never did it because I was trying to do it. It's, everything I've done has just been me.
Mm-hmm.
Like everything, fashion, when I look back, I'm like, oh my God, them finger waves were so tight to my head with that black gel, and I thought I was so fly.
Uh-huh.
But it was just me, everything, you know, from clothes that I wore back then, my face. I had makeup like two shades lighter, but I didn't care, you know. Uh-huh. So and now a lot of times I always tell people that I didn't listen to the radio, and I think I might have said that before here, but I didn't listen to the radio and I didn't watch TV at a point too in my career, and that's how I was able to become even more creative, because I didn't hear nor see. Because when you hear and see, then you find yourself mimicking other people, or you become afraid to try something new because it don't sound like or look like everything else.
Yep. When I listen to, and I'm curious, because when I listen to out the Iconology project, Iconology.
Yay.
The fuck out of here. You know what I'm talking about? Iconology. Hey. And I listen to, what was the one we world premiere? Was it Throw It Back?
Yeah.
Yeah, Throw It Back. And I listen to the sound of Throw It. I always wonder how folks either adjust to what's happening now or move forward while now it's happening.
Right.
And I felt when I heard the track that she blended right in, but still gave us unique Missy. So approaching this project, I know coming up, you stayed away from the TV and stayed away from the radio. Yeah. It's a different era now.
Oh, yeah.
You know, how did you approach this project in terms of sound, in terms of what you want to do as a vocalist, vocal performance, and how you're going to write?
I pretty much, now it's hard to stay away from it because on your phone it's just...
It's there.
There. Mm-hmm. So you have no choice but to see and hear everything. You know, I still just do me. I'm in the room and I have some, a guy named Mikey and Willie. They young kids that I brought on the team too. And, you know, they great at everything they do. And whatever it is, I can still be Missy and then I can still appreciate what's happening now. Cause I remember in the beginning when the change first shifted, it was like, whoa, where are we going with this? Yeah. But now I'm just like, oh, this the ratchet. I'm feeling this. I love a little bit of ratchet every now and again. Uh-huh. So, you know, I keep people around to that if I don't hear, they, you know, my eyes and ears. And a lot of times I go off a feeling.
Mm-hmm.
If I hear something, I hear a beat, then regardless of what it is, if it makes me feel, because when I write things, I have to be able to see it visually, what I'm going to do.
Yeah. Mm. So it's just if you hear a beat, things just come to mind like that?
Yeah. That's why I say, you know, what you finna do?
But you heard the beat, man. She didn't come to mind. I'm just saying. Yeah.
Listen, you should have caught me last night when I had to take cough syrup because sick. Man. And I was on that syrup, that cough syrup.
Okay.
And
you were like, leaning, huh?
Oh, no, not leaning. No, not leaning. I was on regular cough syrup, but I had, you know, medication for my cold.
Mm-hmm.
But I probably would have been in here rapping like Twista out of it, going fast.
Damn, man. See, don't be teasing us.
I love Twista, by the way.
Twista's the bomb, man. Yes. The Why I Still Love You song.
Yes.
Is that just you or who's on that song?
Timbaland did the music underneath. Mm-hmm. And how that came about, well, my mother always been in the church, and my father, God rest his soul, he always had the R&B playing. And so I had the best of both worlds because content-wise, I used to listen to what the R&B records, you know, content-wise was saying. And then the gospel, I listened to the harmonies. And so I just blended the two. And it kind of reminded me of, because I'm a big fan of James Brown work. Uh-huh. And James Brown was a typical example of meshing, you know.
Our soul,
yes,
R&B.
Yes, the soul with gospel. Yeah. And Little Richard, you know, so I said I'm gonna take and make a ratchet quartet, and mix it together and just, you know, do that. And I just started snapping my finger and singing something, and I was like, oh, this kind of hot, and you know. And then I got with Tim and I said I need some music underneath, and he was on Drip Demeanor too.
There it is.
And I ask myself why. Hey.
Oh, my bad.
No.
The mic was on.
You know what?
Let's not do that.
You're getting all excited.
You're a different icon, family.
know I do, man. If I feel it, I go with it.
Practice first, Sway.
Practice. Missy says she don't practice. She just feel it and then come.
Okay, so when you get the Video Vanguard Award, the Songwriter of the Songwriter Hall of Fame, all these platinums, then you don't have to practice either, Sway. But right now, practice.
I'm just saying, man. Missy here. Sure.
Go with it.
The Songwriters Hall of Fame.
It's crazy.
Yes.
Is that one of the ones that's just at the pinnacle for you?
I didn't even, to be honest, the Songwriter Hall of Fame, I didn't even ever think of that because I thought it was just too impossible to reach. And but, you know, God has showed me each time that he's in control, clearly, because I didn't, you know, think that I was going to be on the Super Bowl. I didn't think I was going to get, you know, doctorates. I didn't think I was going to get the Songwriter Hall of Fame. I don't know about the Video Vanguard, the Michael Jackson Video Vanguard Award, because my fans was going, it was going to be a problem on that one.
So. I needed to happen. I don't know why it didn't happen sooner.
Same.
Yeah, same.
Well, I'm glad that it didn't. You know why? And I was telling people, I did an interview yesterday, and they said, you know, we wish that we had your kind of spirit. Because I said, once again, when you have that connection to God like that, even though I got Trip Demeanor and Pussy Don't Feel Me Now, right, you know, those
kind
of, I'm just saying.
Eat it like a vulture.
But when you have that connection like that, you can see that the time wasn't then, and the time was now. Because one of the things that I said was technology wasn't, they didn't have that for those other award shows. And for the type of performer that I am and the performance that I wanted to give, I needed what happened yesterday when you saw that spaceship hovering over the crowd like that,
that was
and
amazing.
People being sucked into it. I believe that is God's time that I'm on.
Very true. I agree with the God's timing, absolutely. But I think you may have been one of the first people that when your name was announced, everybody was like, she doesn't have one already? Like,
yeah.
people thought that you had it already because you were always so ahead of your time. Even when we looked at the video where she had the suit on, the spaceship suit with the M, we was like, Missy had the Google email, the mail logo before Google even knew that they was going to use that.
A lot of people thought that. And that's just like Buster. You know, Buster, I said his name because he's
speech,
another one of those people that I most definitely feel is worthy of getting that because he has videos that I've looked at and I'm like, dang, I wish I'd have done that shit.
I'm curious because we've seen people like Ice Cube or Hype Williams. Hype Williams probably a better example because y'all work together, who's went from making videos to making films. You know what I mean? And I think about all of y'all history, everybody that came from VA, you know, from Pharrell to yourself to Timberland.
Push.
Pusher, you know, all of these.
Chris Brown. Drama. Everybody.
Everybody.
Lex Luger, I'm make sure I say.
Keep saying
VA.
That.
Mask skills.
Don't forget Mask Skills. Got your head
skills,
nodding.
That's my brother.
Yeah, man.
Love to him.
Pen game is crazy, too. Have you ever, or have you thought about, I've seen these biopics that people did not like, especially the one with Aaliyah. I guess you feel the same way. Yeah.
Keep going.
Okay. So here's the thing. Why not now, and we talk about this all the time, we got to preserve our own legacies.
Yes.
And we got to be hands-on.
Yes.
Why, have you ever considered doing a biopic or
for
Aaliyah?
Well, one for myself, I respect, you know, her family.
Okay.
And so when they are ready to, do one, I'm quite sure that they will do one. Because people don't understand, like, when someone passes away, it, you know, for everybody else, we can continue to go on. But for them, they have to live that each and every day. And so when they are ready, then, you know, I'm quite sure they will do that.
Okay.
And we respect that.
You ready for yours?
Oh yeah, I'm gonna do it on myself.
Yeah. Yeah. Have you started?
We are talking.
You're talking?
Yes.
When you say we, who are we? Are they over there on the couch? Or are they? Because you're your own boss. Some imaginary friends.
Yeah, no, my imaginary friends. We most definitely have a communication. Yes, we are talking.
You are talking? Okay. I'm looking forward to that.
Same here.
Because I want to hear everybody's. I want our stories to be told correctly.
That's yes. a fact.
Without yes. the voice, without the made up. Nuances to yes. it. Mm-hmm. I want our stories now to be told by us, written
while
by
we,
us.
While we're here.
While we're here. Yes. Right? Missy Elliott, I'm going to let these callers get in too. Tracy.
Missy, going back to the video Vanguard Award, I can't help but think of Dave Myers, you know?
Oh, yes.
And I know his name through the collaborations with you, you know, 11 music videos, also does great music videos for Kendrick.
Yes.
Can you speak about probably maybe the wildest ideas that you guys put together, how it happened, the video that maybe sticks out the most for you and some story behind it?
Oh, God, it's so many. I mean, Get Your Freak On. Dave is one of them types that he gonna make it happen.
Yeah.
You know, and just at the last minute, you know, I guess one of my imaginary friends was like, you need a chandelier. And I was like, I want a chandelier. And mind you, we had spent mad money already. And he was like, okay, well, we'll get you a chandelier. He thinking it's just a regular, like, mm-hmm. house chandelier. I'm like, no, I need one to swing from. Mm-hmm. He like, what? I'm like, no, I need one to swing from. And you see my size, so it got to be a big one. And he like, okay. I mean, mm-hmm. and before I know it, they was reeling in uh-huh. a chandelier.
Wow.
On past that Dutch.
Uh-huh.
The, you know, people, they were talking and they had me rigged, and I guess they just got in a deep conversation and they let it go, and I fell on both of my knees.
Oh,
and I thought, yeah, I was messed up for past that Dutch.
Oh my
messed
gosh.
Up. But
how bad was the injury?
Oh, super bad.
Yeah?
Yeah. But I had
super
to keep
duper
going.
Super duper bad?
Super duper bad. I had to keep going. I mean, you know, she's a bitch, which that was done with hype.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I had to, two of my dancers, they had asthma attacks because we were really underwater holding our breath. And again, I think the workers just started having just conversation with each other
mm-hmm.
and forgetting that we was underwater. And my dancers, you know, they started falling off them. It was crazy. So it's always been something. The rain, that was probably the craziest one because I had to go to a gas station to be pumped.
Uh-huh.
And
the suit?
Yeah. So once I was pumped all the way up, they realized that I was too big to get in the car.
Yeah.
So I had to walk down the street in Brooklyn.
Wow.
Oh, in Brooklyn, gosh. In this big blow-up
old Brooklyn.
Suit. Yes. To get to the set, and I had deflated.
Oh,
by the time
so yes.
How many miles was that?
Oh, it's far. It's far. Like, it's crazy. Wow. So it's always been.
It was worth it, though.
Yeah.
Oh,
yes.
Man. But yeah, man, that was a groundbreaking video, though.
Oh, yeah.
Yes, I mean, yeah, that set a whole new tone. You know, I want to ask you about the young lady. It's Allison Stowe. Is it Stowe?
She was at the.
Yeah, the young dancer.
Yes. Because yes. mm-hmm. we bumped into her. Where were we? We were at the European Music Awards.
Oh, wow.
And we saw her. And seeing her on the stage, mm-hmm. it's to see. That's a career that you launched.
Mm-hmm.
And it was funny, like, just running into her because we shot work at 17 years ago.
Uh-huh. Mm.
And to hug her was like, I felt like I was back at work and she was the little child again.
Uh-huh.
And it was just amazing because I said I couldn't do... you know, work it without her being there because she's a big part of it. Because a lot of times when, you know, years went on, people always would be like, what happened to the little white girl?
Mm-hmm.
It was breakdancing yeah. and working. Mm-hmm. And so I was like, you know, and I say, well, we're going to have to put your name on the back because you'd have cut your hair short. And then 17 years later, they might be like, who this lady?
Right. Right.
So, but yeah, she's still amazing.
She's amazing.
So amazing.
Queen Latifah helped close the show with Naughty by Nature, with Do It All from Lords of the Underground. Red Man was
big
there.
Wyclef.
Fetty Wap.
Huge.
Fetty Wap mm-hmm. did extremely well.
Huge.
I, you know, Lil' Kim has her reality series
Love.
Now.
That's my sis.
Angie Martinez, of course, is killing it over at yes. Power on, here in New York.
She got a show coming,
yeah, new
too.
Show,
she got a
yeah.
new show coming, too. Yeah. Mary J. Blige. It's Mary J. Blige.
Come on,
man.
This is Mary.
This is the crew right here.
This the crew. Like, the crew still, like, hanging yes. out? Y'all doing, what y'all do, Sunday dinners? Or what?
Kim, I talk to all the time. La, I talk to all the time. Mm-hmm. Mary, I told her, yeah, we all talk. Like, and that's the thing about it. It was never for the cameras.
Mm-hmm.
You know, we really have been sincere friends. We at each other's houses. Mm-hmm. Like, mm-hmm. so it was never like, let's do this because we about to, you know, do a record together. We really genuinely are friends. Mm-hmm. And so we talk all the time. Actually, I'm going to Mary's show, I believe. So she's here.
She's here in New York? Yeah. Okay. What do y'all? How's the conversation changed over the years though? Before it was probably you going on tour. Who you going on tour with? Now what is it?
Man, it's crazy out here. And Mary be like, don't make me go back to 1995, Mary.
Oh,
like, you know, so it, you know, it's like that now, because you know it is it's different. And I thank God that we dodged that, because we mm-hmm. used to party down.
Yeah.
So I'm glad that we wasn't in the, you know.
Yeah, the camera phone.
The social media era. Mm-hmm. So, but yeah, that's pretty much our conversation. We always laugh about that, like, wow.
Do y'all give it, like, now I got guys that have been in the business for decades now that I know, that we hang out, whether it was through journalism or radio or just music right. business. And now we're talking about different things now. It's like, hey, man, did you invest in that one stock I told you about? You know what I mean? Hey, man, you putting that aside in those savings right
yeah,
now?
Right.
Hey,
family,
man, you going health. To that therapy?
Yeah, right.
You yes. know, y'all yes. having those too?
Nah, I ain't gonna lie. You're not
starting investment groups and buying up the block or nothing?
Susu, I mean, look, I got 7 cribs and I own them all.
Hello.
I everything is paid for, okay. So we good.
Eat it like a vulture.
So,
oh shit, good for you, Missy.
Yes, and you know, business is handled. I think it's just more about. I think we just like to hear each other's voice. Now, me and La, we speak mm-hmm. about business deals, because actually we just did a project. It's the Clock Sisters movie that come out
mm-hmm.
2020. So, and me, Mary, and Latifah uh-huh. Executive produced that project.
Wow. Oh, gosh,
there we go. That's what we want to hear, Missy. Share that great. Shit. It's like the old days. You ain't got to hide it. Kids don't hide nothing no more.
Yeah. Right. Because look, when we used to come in, it was nobody. Like, I'm like,
damn.
It's mad cameras.
Yeah.
You know, you used to have to come in. You ain't had to worry about no makeup and nothing. You just,
yeah.
baby, not no on. More. They zoom different, in on man. Their face man. Like, oh, my goodness. What's up with her hair?
Yeah. Like that, though, man.
Yeah.
You gave an amazing performance. I'm at the MTV VMAs.
Thank you.
Thank you for that.
Thank you.
All right. I want to open up these phone lines, but I want to play Drip Demeanor.
Mm. Oh, God.
Unless you want to play something else.
No, I love that's actually one of my faves.
Cause that thing.
That's
dang.
I wish is Grayson here? Oh, okay, cause I've been telling my label, like, that's the lick.
That's the thing right there.
That's the lick.
Yeah, yeah. See, I always go for the one I think is the lick first, and then I'll ask the artists what they want to hear.
No,
but
that's it.
Oh
well, I'm coming with that next anyway. So
that's the next single. Yeah. Okay, y'all, I want to ask that next question. All right, we're gonna play Drip Demeanor. Sway in the Morning. You want to talk with Missy? 888-742-3345.
This is a Missy.
The greatest of all time, Missy Elliott.
Yes.
Missy Elliott. I gotta let these callers get in.
Okay.
If you don't mind.
Yes.
All right. We go quick questions. We'll get quick answers. Angela in Chattanooga. Good morning, Angela.
Angela.
Good morning. Good morning. Sway, happy to be on the show.
What's up, girl?
I just want to say thank you to Miss, because 400 years ago, black people, slaves, and peace service landed in the 757. And this week, a black woman from the 757 has entered Hall of Fame and gotten Vanguard Award. Thank you for shouting out Virginia.
Wow. That was deep.
In that context, that's deep.
Yes, that's crazy.
You got like a great grandfather, grandmother right now that's smiling down on you.
I hope my ancestors are happy and proud.
That's
what I aim.
Okay, well, listen, honestly, in all seriousness, that's who those voices are.
Right.
That's who the imaginary from we joke.
Right, and you know, but it's so funny. I always tell people, you know, my family, a lot of them probably thought I was crazy because I used to write on the walls all the way up until high school. And even when I left the house, it still had, you know, the writings of songs. And maybe them people was telling me, they was giving me the lyrics.
That's what it is, Missy. We figured that out today. We never even realized
that. Seriously, Jadena said the same thing when he was up here, remember?
Jadena did say
that. Yeah, and how he collaborates with his ancestors, and he just sees himself as a vessel.
Yes, I don't know. I mean, you know, I most definitely know that God is in control, and I thank my family because I come from a praying family, and that's another thing that has gotten me through all these years is coming from a praying family.
Y'all pray together?
Stay prayed up.
Yeah, you gotta stay prayed up.
Stay prayed up.
Yeah, yes. All right, we got Trey from Colorado on the line. What up, Trey?
What up, Trey?
What's going on, y'all? Thank you, Missy, for what you've done for music.
Your
impact, you do not understand.
Believe me.
I have a question.
Yes.
What haven't you done that you still want to do?
A lot more movies. Most definitely. And I wanna direct people videos for sure. Cause I've never really been I wasn't even supposed to. I had got to a place where I wasn't gonna be an artist. And of course Sylvia Rome, I wanted to have just a label, and they was like, well, we'll give you a label if you give us an album. And that one album turned into 6 albums. That's what I like to do. I like to just help groom people. You know, because I see artists sometimes and I say, hey, you know, the labels, you need to get people back in their real A&Rs. Not to say that there are not any real A&Rs, because I have one myself. But to, you know, go over those things and not just throw the artists out there. Like, you know, make sure, I remember Mary and Jodeci and them, they used to rehearse when they didn't even have shows.
Wow.
So when they had those shows, they was prepared. And so those are the things that I, you know, would like to see happen.
You had good manage. You've always had, I feel like, you know better than me, but Mona Scott around you.
Oh, yes.
You know, Chris Lighty, the late, great Chris Lighty.
Yes, Violator.
Violator. Is there anything, like, Chris, I always want to celebrate his presence in this music business.
Yes.
Anything he said or did that sticks to you now that you could pull from?
Chris was always a business person. I never forget one time in Miami, I hit him and I said, Chris, you know, they having a party and they got my name on the flyer. And he said, don't say nothing. Do not say nothing. I was so mad. I was like, well, how they gonna have my name on a flyer? And he said, listen, I got you. Chris let this party go on and pulled up at the end of the night. And was like, now get her money. Like, and that's, you know, it's stuff like that, because he was like, let it go through. Like, and I couldn't understand. And he was like, yo, just trust me. I got you. And he pulled up right at that club and got my bread.
Got that bread.
Bread that, you know, it wasn't even no kind of contract. He just was like, get up.
Wow. That's work. Chris Lighty, man. Great one, man, right there. C-Buck is from the Bay. What up, C-Buck?
C-Buck.
Hey, what's up, Sway? What's happening, Mr.
Hey.
Missy Misdemeanor, man. Missy Misdemeanor, you're such a blessing. Oh, my God.
Thank you.
I know you got a lot of calls, but I missed a chance to see Tweet at the Redwoods in Oakland. Sway, he hosts sometimes. He come through. Tweet had some family, death in the family, something like that, back in Miami or something. So we missed out on seeing her. I never seen you. So when you guys coming out?
I don't know. Actually, I just talked to Tweet week before last, so we trying to get back in the studio and get some joints cooked up. So
nice.
Yeah. Oh yeah. Wow, man, that's gonna be good.
That's my sister.
I saw you at Essence. Oh. I went to Essence to see you because that's my first Essence.
Oh wow!
Wow, you know, and
that's crazy.
That's my first Essence. My first Essence, because it always happens around my birthday, and I'm usually taking my grandmother and family on a trip, like to the lake and fishing with the kids and all of that. And
right.
this year I didn't do it, so this one was trying to convince me to go, and then she told me you were headlining. I was like, you know what?
I'm there.
Did you have fun?
What? Come on. You know what I love most? So we had Monica on here. There was a point when Monica came out and the crowd went, whoa.
Yes.
Shout out to Monica.
Yes. Big shout out to Monica and Trina. They both came out. And, you know, Monica, both of them are like that, though. I call them up and they just like, what time you need me to be there?
Mm-hmm.
And Monica, you know, she gonna be like, well, what y'all wearing? Polka dots. I just get a, you know, a polka dot shirt and a cute shoe and some jeans. I'm good. And she's so dope with it. Monica ain't even show up for sound check. Monica like, just tell me where I walk to. Yeah. She been doing this forever.
Wow. It came out blowing. So yes. So I'm imagining the iconology tour. Right now, I'm imagining things. Heather, help me
out.
Okay, so what are you seeing? We're seeing Timberland coming by.
Oh, yes.
Yes.
Okay. Making live beats.
Yes. Okay. Live beats on stage. Yeah. We see that, right?
Yeah.
Yes. We see Monica.
You got, because Missy got to say, new Monica.
And it's funny you said that.
Yeah.
Because I was going to have Tim to do that for the Video Vanguard, Michael Jackson Video Vanguard Award.
Mm-hmm.
I was going to have him do that. But they only gave me 7 minutes and 15, which I'm so thankful for. But I didn't have enough time. But that was one of the things.
Oh,
yeah. That I was
wow, to create beats live on stage.
They gave JT 14 or 15.
Mm. Yeah.
That's your homie, JT, ain't it?
They gave me that. But, I mean, you know what?
I'm messing with you.
In a weird way, I'm fine with that, because I'm like, at the end of the day, I'm a cram, and we're going to destroy this stage.
Yeah.
And them little amount of seconds, and that little time, we're going to try to fit as many things as we could possibly.
But it
felt
longer than that, though. Nah, and the way you killed it, though, like the pacing was so insane.
It felt long to me because I was backstage fighting, like, to keep changing clothes. That was the scary thing. I lost my necklace. As a matter of fact, if anybody see a gold diamond necklace, look, I'll give a reward. I posted that today. Like, I really did lose my necklace in the middle.
What's the reward?
Find it first. Okay,
you're smart. Because if you say it, somebody, who would that happen to? Ryan Leslie said he's going to give somebody $1 million to find his laptop, and that person took him to court. So who did we say? Pharrell is going to make some guest appearances.
Big shout out to Pharrell, too, because I don't know if we said Pharrell in the VA lineup.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And big shout out to Virginia, 2 Up, 2 Down.
Yeah.
And the whole DMV area, y'all too. So I want to make sure I
That's
shout
the
them
tour,
out.
The VA, you know, take the VA, take them all out on tour.
Yes. I wish we could.
Why you can't?
I mean, we can, but we got to get somebody to pick it up. Because I most definitely am coming with the set.
Okay.
And so they probably be like, after that set, because I know MTV probably was like, girl, you got other performers.
Wow, man. So iconology. Why did you title the EP Iconology?
It's, you know, a study of visuals. Mm-hmm. And I believe that I'm an artist of visuals. You know, for one, I think that's kind of, if you don't kind of get my records immediately, especially like earlier stages when people didn't know what that sound was, I think the video was the puzzle to it, to see it visually. Because you might have been like, well, I don't know if I like this, because the cadence was different from anything that was out at the time when Tim come with that cat kind of cadence. So I had to have visuals to kind of make people see how you bounce to it. Because we've been bouncing way back then. Like, people bouncing now, we've been doing that way back then. We've been doing sound effects way back then. Yeah. All the skirt. Yeah. I did that at Gossip Folks way, I don't know how many years ago. But those things, the visual is a big part of it. And so it's, you know, studying of visuals and just how to be an icon.
How to be an icon.
Yes.
A classy one at that.
Yes, indeed.
And all the sound effects that we hear in a lot of the newer aged trap influence music, do the research. There's nothing new under the sun.
Never.
Missy was doing those sound effects way before that. Yes.
And I have to laugh because sometimes people, you know, if you do it, then people be like, oh, you trying to fit in? No, actually, you go back to Gina Thompson. When I say, all the, like, I've been screaming on tracks.
You were doing, you did that too?
And Gina Thompson.
The things you do.
The things you do? Play that, play that, pull that up. That joint was the joint too. Who produced that? Did you produce that too?
No, that was Rodney Jerkins.
Rodney Jerkins.
And Puffy did the remix.
Oh, so we got that one too? Hold up. Let us know. We mentioned her producing prowess too, Missy Elliott.
So much, it's that Jeep summertime bang shit right here. Had to make sure your edges was right.
Got it. All right, here go. 4, 3, 2.
For Puff Daddy, beware, how dare he make the remix so deadly, cause Al, Gumo be my pal like Shazam, I'm running to you like shoes, oh you who's, and I choose from the fly things, forget that you do, ooh, you dudes can't you see like total, kissing you got Gina running for the boulder. Hit me on my car phone, got the hydro with me and you can roll, we can take a stroll on the beach, but bad boy, don't take your love away from me.
Come on, man. That's the proof. Case closed. What year did that come out?
96, 97.
What was that?
Probably 96.
96, 23 years ago. Y'all weren't even born. Stop.
Before edge control, but your edges was laid. That's when you had to have the toothbrush.
That's why you didn't know.
You had your toothbrush game when them edges had to. There wasn't no edge control back this
you had
way.
The toothbrush?
What?
Yeah.
Listen.
Yes. What?
Different time.
Damn.
I hate you for that. I really do.
I'm just telling you a fact.
Sorry.
What you drop? Another necklace? No, shit. I'm
looking
because
I'm
going to
grab this.
What is that?
Missy, it's right there, Missy. It might have been the back to her earring.
Took it off the floor, Missy. Look, I got you.
Look. At my house, I lay on the floor. And I have chairs.
Okay.
I lay on the floor because you know what? It keeps me close to humility.
There it is. Grounded. I ain't mad at that.
I most definitely... ain't always have.
Okay,
so
okay. You was feeling yourself once at one point?
Look,
what stage of your career? Let's look at the albums. Which album was you like, did you kind of get, was it during the Real World album?
You know what, actually, and I have to say this, because this is the no, I wasn't even feeling myself then.
Okay.
But I just feel like I felt like that when I hit Jay and I said, congratulations. To him and for becoming a billionaire.
Mm-hmm.
And he mentioned the fact that he remembered when I had my Lamborghini, and that was the first time he had gotten one. And I was like, wow, now that's huge. And this was years ago, so that's when I was like, oh, wait.
He was loud to feel
you. Yeah, you know, I've one thing about me, you know, even after the Super Bowl, I remember my friends hitting me up and saying, you know, let's go party. You ain't doing nothing. I'm like, no, I'm in the house mopping my floors. Like, I'm so regular. Like, I go to the grocery store in my jogging pants, T-shirt. I don't have, you know, a bunch of people running around feeling like they have to, you know, do a whole bunch of stuff for me. I just... Because when I go home, when I go to Virginia, my family don't care. You dirty up that dish, you going to wash it.
You going to wash that dish.
Mm-hmm. I don't care what you just came from doing.
You're going to wash it with that award in your hand. Put the award on the table, damn it. That's great to know. I'm just imagining you in the produce section, you know, just filling them. It, like, that's dope. That's how I see it anyway, Missy. Yes. And I want to say congratulations.
Yeah.
We ain't even at halftime yet. Come on. Dope. Oh, wow. You're just playing in the second quarter right now.
Yes.
Okay. Iconology is out now, and that's the EP.
Get it.
Missy Elliott, the greatest.
Yes.
The greatest of an entire era, ladies and gentlemen.
Oh, Lord. You going to have them kids trying to come and blast my page.
Check it. Let them kids come. And guess what they're going to do?
They agree.
Exactly. Let the church say amen.
Amen. They're going to discover.
Fuck out of here.
They're going to find out what's right, and they're going to appreciate you even more.
You was in elementary school when I was platinum.
Kids.
Fuck out of here.
I went, well, you weren't even born yet. What you talking about? Fuck out of here. Missy Ellie, that's Missy. Any kid come at you, send them our way. You got squad, Missy. Yeah. All right? Make sure y'all get the project. Look out for Missy on tour. Thank you. You know we love you, sis.
Yes, I love you.
Continue success. Your nails look amazing. I don't know what the hell that looked like. You got that from a pyramid, like lost treasure. You put on your fingertips right there. Give Nefertiti her nails.
Slick Rick nails. That's a slick Rick.
Damn. That motherfucker looks great. Yeah. Y'all want to hit Missy up on social, you can at
Missy Elliott on Twitter and Missy Misdemeanor Elliott on, because they took my name. That's why that thing's so long, because people like, yo, that thing is forever. So Missy Misdemeanor Elliott on IG.
Okay, cool. And Iconology.
Yes, Iconology. Throw it back video and song is out too right now.
So you can hear this back. Make sure you check it out. You can hear this back at SiriusXM.com/
On Demand.
And we will be posted on SwaysUniverse.com and YouTube channel tomorrow. I'm at Real Sway across the board. Until next time, ladies and gentlemen, we have nothing left to say.